Hello, Lightning Strikes. Thank you so much for tuning back into my channel. I'm so excited to talk to you guys about alternate day fasting. So today is my fast day. It's January 17th. It is my third week doing this. I started January 1st. I have lost about 20 pounds since the beginning of the month. I feel amazing. That's the most important thing. My energy is I genuinely feel like I'm taking a free antidepressant. I don't even understand how doing nothing can be so rewarding, which makes me get into the three more important tips that you need to remember when you're pursuing intermittent fasting or alternate day fasting. You need to relax. This is a relaxing weight loss method. It's all relaxing. The more you relax and chill out, the better your body feels, okay? Lean back. It should not feel like you're controlling yourself from food. Here and there, you may like go to the grocery store or be out in public and you smell some Brazilian steakhouse, right? But you're just, try and remember, it's not an act of controlling, it's an act of leaning back and an act of receiving this blessing your body's doing. And a lot of times fasting can seem like it's stressful. Oh my gosh, you know. Oh, yeah. No, just relax. I actually have no other advice. Maybe we can talk into how I relax. So right now, let me talk about right now, how I feel right now. So right now, the whole day for my fast, I have felt pretty steady. So I ate about 3,500 calories. I ate good. And I'm going to make a video like tomorrow. I have, I'm cooking dinner. I'm responsible for dinner tonight, tomorrow. So I'm going to post like what I eat in a day, alternate day fasting, and you'll be shocked. But right now I have gone the whole day. It has been probably one of the easier days. I think I'm getting the hang of it. I didn't really feel hungry today. Around 3 p.m. my energy did dip and I did take a nap, but I also had been lacking a little bit of sleep because I have so much energy, guys. I slept at 1 and woke up at 7, 1 a.m. and woke up at 7 and went the whole day, drank one cup of coffee, one cup of bone broth, and I felt amazing. I have not done that in months. Like, usually I'm feeling like dead inside from 6 hours of sleeping. I need to usually be asleep by like 9, 10 p.m. in order to be up early. So recently I've been waking up early because I have all this energy ready to be used, ready to be burned, ready to like just do stuff. Like it's a miracle. Like, I genuinely believe it's nothing short of a miracle to me. So another thing that I've been doing is staying away from stress. I want to add more miracle onto this miracle. So I don't embrace stress. I don't embrace anxiety. I don't embrace anything that makes me feel less than feminine. I just don't. If I'm stressed, I keep it acute. I keep it today, you know, but especially if it's something that goes into the future, if I start to think of alternate day fasting, like for the rest of the year, I'll only be eating half of the days for the rest of the year. If I think of it like that, I will have a panic attack and shy away. So one of the things also I've been doing is just, I don't even think about the year. I just think about, I for sure can go at least today without eating. Like, I don't know about March, April, May, and June, but today I can for sure do it. And that's also a way been keeping my energy away from stress, because my energy doesn't need to be in the future. Like, that's the last place that shit needs to be. That wonderful, jewel bedazzled shit needs to be. Energetic optimism and visualization. So another thing that's been getting me through my fast is like the day when I wake up, I visualize how successful I'm going to be. So I visualize the fast going smoothly. I get my food. I drink my bone broth. I see myself say no. I see myself leaning back into the ketosis and the autophagy. I see myself like being in self-control. I'm seeing myself winning every battle that the fasting brings. And it is definitely a key component into keeping me on track. Visualization, being busy, Don't be sitting there watching Netflix with no food when you know you like to watch it with chocolate covered popcorn and a glass of wine. Like, you need to also change up your routine. So also for me, on my fasting days, I'll do more work than I would do on my feast days, which is kind of beneficial because I also have way more focus and way more energy and way more discipline on the fast days than I do on my feast days. So it's kind of like working out. I want to see how that works. I did read a new book about fasting, and it did say that women should not fast around their period, and I think my period's like starting at any moment now. Because I found that information out way before January 1st when I started, and I have a big problem with my thing is I'm committed. When I say I'm going to do something, I do it. I finish it. I don't play when it comes to that. I am compulsive when it comes to that. Even if that means we have to change the goalpost, it has to be done. And so the reason I'm like that is because I've just learned to be like that. It has to get done. Slow or steady or fast, it gets done. Okay. So, it definitely it doesn't, and people say like that's OCD. No, that's called fucking hard work, bitch. Get the program. It gets done. Every time I don't get it done, I feel so guilty. And then it doesn't expand my energy. It supports a belief system that I'm not capable. It supports a belief system. It adds, because a lot of times when it comes to why we haven't achieved something is because we're not stacking that fucking evidence about, well, who we are. If every single time, like, that's also one thing that helped me get deep deliverance in psychological mental health. There comes a certain time, like it almost makes me tear up. There comes a certain time when I was depressed from like 17 to 22. There come the one of a big reason why I'm not as depressed is because there comes a time when I'm like, I have gone back up so many times. What's new? And I feel like that's kind of like where the universe kind of wanted me. Like, it's like, what's new? Get into it. Get back up. Get back up. Get back up. One of the times you get back up, you're on track. Somehow it works. So it's like, what I was saying, trying to say is, what was I trying to say? Get back up. Get back up. I don't know what that train of thought was. So, oh yeah, my business, now my mindset. Yeah. So now I'm just the type of person where it's like, if it doesn't get done, it gets done, it gets done. If I like, so for example, my goal is, I'll just be transparent. My goal is to post a YouTube video a day. So that kind of looks a lot of ways. That could be just sitting on my laptop making a video. That could be making a video of what I eat in a day. That could be so many things, but it needs to get done, right? And so a lot of times in my pro, the reason it hasn't been done is because of everything I just taught you, that's literally telling you about how, like, telling you that it needs, I'm trying to get my body into the frequency of someone who posts daily. And so when you're someone like this, of course you're gonna fail. And that's just normal. And you will fail. One day, if you're trying to be a YouTuber and you have a goal of posting a video a day, you will fail that, but that doesn't you own but you only truly energetically fail when you stop trying. So don't stop trying. And one day it will be momentum, it'll all work out, and it'll all work out. So energetic optimism and visualization, I'm just feeling so happy and optimistic. So right now I have how many more minutes? It's 8:50, so that means I have 3 hours until I eat my meal. So I also, because of that article, I was gonna do a 36-hour fast. That's also what I was gonna do 36 hours, but because of the article that said that as a woman, you probably don't want to do that around. You don't want to fast the week before your period. I'm not doing that, but I can shorten my fast to 24 hours. So I do also, that's why I forgot what my inner dialogue was earlier today. So I will be eating at 12. So how I get ready for the evening is that I end my workday with a 30-minute jog, and it has been revolutionary because if you work for yourself and you're high level, if you're someone who focuses a lot, I don't know about you, but I can't seem to turn it off. the run kind of gets me in the energy of turn it off, let it relax, because you have to focus a lot in order to jog. And sometimes I do a walk as well, but it helps kind of make me turn off. And then I'll be asleep by 12, and then I'll be up by like 7 or 8 in the morning. I only need about 7 to 8 hours of sleep. So I'll sleep from 12:30 to 8 or 7. And we will talk tomorrow. So I am still developing the course. It'll be out. I changed the due date to January 30th because that I was writing in the before I made my alternate day fasting course. I had my other course, which was, what was my other course? It was Atomic Transformation, which I think I want alternate day fasting to be my first course because there's a lot of, it's basically the same thing. Okay. There's basically teaching the same thing, but this one has a more tangible, if you can't get the fasting part, I have to feed you guys slowly. If you don't get the fasting, Atomic Transformation will just, it won't make sense to you because you won't even have the right foundation to understand what it means to hold your frequency if you can't even hold your appetite. And so, where are we going to go into this? So I feel really good. Let me just say, has any miracle been happening? I will say today, what miracle happened today? I'm not gonna lie. I was feeling really down and out because I've been on social media for, I don't feel I should share that. Yep, that is not what I want to share. So, I'll talk about it's the 17th, it's been 17 days of my fasting journey, and I want to talk about what has any miracles that have happened. So a miracle that happened recently is I don't get breakdowns as much compared to when I was in my early 20s, my young 18, 19, 20, 21. Like, Jesus, I would cry so much. I'd cry like all day. I'll cry from just the second I wake up, I'm doing my makeup, I'm crying. In the afternoon, I'm crying. Evening, I'm crying. So I don't really cry as much at all. If anything, I'm crying positive tears. But I did have a moment of weakness today. I had a moment of like, whoa, is this going to happen? Is my dream going to happen? Is it going to happen? Like, and I was just like, it can't, like, it happened. Oh my God. I looked up, I Googled one thing. The first video I watched had everything to do with what I was going through. It was beyond an answered prayer. Like, this was like, there's certainly some teachers who, God just gives them this extra juice of information. Like, it's just, it's so beautiful because it was just one of the most revelating things. One of them was the principle of, I really want to share this. This was really interesting. So I was an Abraham Hicks sermon. I think I'll try and find it and put in the link below. I'm gonna find it and put in the link below for you guys. So she was talking about how when you first give birth to that, by the time you declare and set a goal for something you want to envision it, your energetics assumes it's the baby that's in your stomach. Like, it's a baby that hasn't been born. And then when it becomes, when I'll say it's a zygote or whatever it's called. It's a cell, it's a fertilized egg that has, it's, and you think that the building phase is the pregnancy stage. When in fact, Abraham Hicks proposes that when you give birth, she proposes a different acronym. Oh, it's so magical. She says the energetics behind this, it's like, she says, what's actually happening is the birth, what happened is when the woman is pregnant, was all the combinations of informations going and swirling in your mind, formulating the desire. So the desire could be likened to a baby because you don't know the sex or the gender of the baby. You don't know who the personality of the baby is. You don't know what the, you don't know shit about that baby. It's being formed. It's the soul is being formed. The information is being downloaded. The genetic, you know, components are happening. The mixing of DNAs, the unraveling of the gene codes are happening. And so is an idea before it has been set into stone and become a fruition of a manifested goal and manifested action toward that goal. And she proposes that by the time the child is born, that in itself holds the same, should hold the same energetic output as your, it's kind of like, and I really hope this is making sense in chronological order. She's saying that, she's so damn smart. She said this in like freaking four sentences and it clicked and unlocked freaking layers. She says that once the baby is born, then that becomes the manifested idea. You wouldn't say, let's say I want to name my child Michael. You wouldn't say, oh, I'm waiting for Michael to arrive, the fullness of Michael to arrive in adulthood. When Michael's there, he's just a baby. Or he's not fully manifested as the fullness of Michael. And so when you start something, don't think that this is the pregnancy stage as you're building. Think of it if it's here and you're now developing it into a functional business, a functional relationship, a functional human, you know, XYZ. So that blew my mind away, and further iterated that time is not real. It is always here. And so she's saying, like, don't keep stressed about your goals not bringing to fruition because it's right literally there, just is not fully manifested. Whew, heavy, heavy stuff. I just had to, like, take a moment and take it. Like, I literally stopped crying. Tears ran back into my eyes and I started my work day. So that felt really good to energetically feel here, be in the embodiment of those words. Jesus, sometimes I listen to Abraham, I have to slow her down, put her in like 0.75, because if I don't, I will not get everything her videos say. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this really helps you guys energetically survive this fast. And bye.